Hey guys, this is better lighting. I just finished reading Every Last Breath by Jennifer L. Armentrout, the last book in the Dark Elements. Wow, my concealer is very bright. The last book in the Dark Elements trilogy. I just finished it and I loved it. Now, I didn't love it in the sense like I love Sarah J. Maas's books and I love Cassandra Clare books. Like, I love those books. It's just like, overall, I loved it. Like, it's a little more than like, it's not like crazy in love with it, but I did really, really enjoy it and I like it a lot. 5 out of 5 stars, favorite in the trilogy. Layla, gosh, like I think I've said in my other two reviews that Layla, it was kind of annoying to me just because like just how naive she seemed to be.
Who are you talking to?
I am recording a video.
Hi.
So yeah, 5 out of 5 stars. I really liked it. Layla wasn't as annoying. Love Roth. It's me, Jessica, and today I'm going to be talking about Every Last Breath by Jennifer L. Armentrout. This is the last book in the Dark Elements trilogy, and I'm going to give this book a 5 out of 5 stars. I personally think it is the best book in the trilogy so far. Oh my goodness. If you don't know anything about this series, our main character, her name is Layla, and she is half demon, half gargoyle, and the gargoyles are called wardens. And so that is what she is. She's half and half. And the wardens, their job is to destroy demons who are on Earth, on the kind of like with us humans walking around, pretend to be humans, and send them back to hell. So that's what the wardens do. So Layla is our main character. She has a conflict about whether or not she should like forsake her demon side and try to be the best warden she can be, or whether she needs to embrace her demon side and realize that she is two things. And then there's also a love triangle. So that's kind of the basis of this trilogy. The love triangle, I think, takes a little more precedent than the actual plot. But other than that, if you're looking for some cheesy romance, this trilogy is for you. So yeah, I really, really enjoyed this book so much more than the other two. So yeah, I'm gonna get into spoilers now. So if you haven't read Every Last Breath or you haven't even read the trilogy, I do have reviews for the other two books, so you guys can go watch those as well. I will link those down in the description. I am so proud of Jennifer L. Armentrout. Why, you ask? Because how long does it? It only takes about 100 pages into this book, and then Layla has finally decided who she's going to be with. You know, it's, you know, Roth or Zane. 100 pages in, we decide that it's gonna be Roth, and I am a happy Jessica. I love Roth, and I loved Layla in this book because of Roth, because of their relationship. I loved how this book wasn't focused on, like, oh, who she's gonna pick. It was focused on their relationship, which I loved so much. I loved it so much. I feel like it was such a cliche dodge to have Roth and Layla get together. And I love that they did. I think just Roth is a better person because of Layla, and Layla is a better person because of Roth, and I feel like that's how a relationship should go. Like, I love that, like, a lot of books in YA now focus on, like, a relationship that is healthy and that is about, you know, treating a person like an equal and loving them and kind of experiencing things with them. Like, I love that that's now, like, a thing. One thing that I really liked about this book was that the ending, when you find out that the boss is like a woman, the devil decides that they want to be a woman for now, and meaning her, and then also like finding out that Layla's butler in the compound of the wardens is like the man upstairs. Like, there's no doubt in my mind that's this man upstairs. So I really, really like that. I like that she got a familiar. I like the part when they go, when Layla goes into the underworld and Bambi was like, I knew you were up to something, girl. That's why I decided that I was gonna be on you as a tattoo for today. And then Robin's like, whatever. That whole sequence with Grimm was pretty great. I like that a lot because he called her out and he was like, ever since you found out that the Lillian is your friend Sam, like, all you've done is decide who you're gonna be with and then had sex with him. And I was like, true? So I really liked that a lot. I like that we got to confront Elijah because I was waiting for that in book two. I was like, when is her like biological father gonna show up? And we finally got that, and then the Lillian shows up and just kills him. Yes. I really also liked that they didn't put Stacy to the sidelines, because normally when, like, after, when you, I feel like when you have a big kind of world-defining moment, and, like, the world is gonna end scenario, the mortal, normal character kind of gets pushed to the side a little bit because we've got this big kind of thing going on, and they didn't do that with Stacy. Like, throughout the middle of the book, that kind of happened, but then it was like she'd pop up and she's like, hey, how you doing? And I feel like her and Zane are gonna get together, which I'm happy for both of them, and I wonder how that's gonna work out. Like, that's all I've gotta say. Yeah, one thing I really, really liked was the climax of the story with her, confronting the Lillian. I really, really liked that. I felt like it didn't have to be so, like, that climax, it wasn't this big climactic fight between the two of them. It was, like, her confronting the Lillian and being like, she's accepting her death in order to kill him, and I felt like it was such a, like, a peaceful type of climax, in a sense, that, like, we had the big fight where Abbott dies, you know? We had that big fight. She realizes that she has to die in order to kill the Lillian. Roth tries to do something to figure out a way to make sure that she doesn't have to die, and they both find out that, like, she has to die. Roth won't accept it. She finally accepts it, and, so she dies. And I really liked that sequence of that kind of line that just happened. I like that. I don't know how to say it, but I like that that's how things happened. The conversation between her and Lillian there at the end, I feel like Lillian, I don't know, because, like, so, like, with Lilith, she makes the deal so that, like, you don't know whether or not it's for Layla's benefit, or it's for Lilith's benefit, because if Layla stays alive, then Lilith stays alive, because they're connected. So, that's just, like, you don't know if Lilith did it to be selfish, or because she loves her daughter, because right before Layla dies, she says that Lilith said that she felt love when holding Layla. I was very, very upset when Roth had to give up Bambi. That made me sad. And, like, I really, like, I guess it kind of was a little bit of a happy ending because, like, the witches allowed both Roth and Layla to come and visit Bambi whenever they wanted. But, like, at the same time, I wish we had Bambi back because she's Bambi, and I love her. So, like, that's the only one thing that I didn't like, was that Bambi was just gone, because I liked her. Like, we have the scene where she finally becomes a human, and you get to see, like, Bambi is such a great character, like, even when she's a snake and she doesn't talk, but then we also got to see her talking, got to see her in, like, a humanoid form, and I really, really like seeing that. And then all of a sudden she's, like, taken away. That is my review for Every Last Breath by Jennifer L. Armentrout. If you liked it, please give it a like and comment down below what your favorite part of the actual trilogy, like the whole trilogy, book 1, 2, and 3, and what your favorite part was. Make sure to subscribe and ring that bell as well so you guys can get notified when I make another video. I will see you guys in the next video. Have a great day. Bye!